Hello everyone, this is Anup Chhabra and today we are going to study about JDBC and the basic necessary steps to work with JDBC. So let us understand what exactly is JDBC. JDBC stands for Java to Database Connection. So the first we will see the five crucial steps to work with JDBC. The first step is to load the driver. So driver is basically used to act as an interpreter between the Java and our database. So first is we load the driver and then we get or establish the connection with the help of drivers. So first we load the driver, then we establish the connection with the help of drivers, then we issue the SQL query via the connection. The fourth step is to process the results via SQL queries. So after processing the results via SQL queries, we move to close all the JDBC objects. So these were the five crucial steps when we work with JDBC. Now we'll understand in brief about the first two steps, and later on we'll move on to the remaining few steps. So with the end of this program, we see that the main function is being declared, and we declare this connection call is equals to none, making this to be a global variable, because as we know we have to close all the JDBC objects. So this has to be a global variable and not a local variable. Then of course when we work with JDBC we come across exceptions, so we have to include try and catch blocks so that we can write the risky lines of code within the try block, and with the catch block we can we'll write the alternate code if we come across any kind of exceptions. So in the first step we see first step is to load the driver. So to load the driver, first we will create an object for java.sql driver with newcom.mysql.jdbc.driver. So object when it will be created, then we move to the driver manager that will register the driver, and this div, which will be the reference variable, object reference variable, we will pass in this. Then if this executes, we will to verify that the driver has been loaded or not, we will write a system.out.println status statement, so that in the output we see that we confirm that the driver is loaded. This statement will be executed, but if we come across any exception in these two lines, this will not be executed. Now after we're done with the first step, that is to load the driver, we will move on to the next step, that is establish the connection with the help of the drivers. So as to establish the connection with the help of driver, we will first mention the URL is nothing but the uniform register location. So here we will mention the location of the database that we have. So this has a particular format which we follow. It should be JDBC with MySQL, that is the application, following which with the local host, since the application is installed in our system only. But if it is the database or the servers is another system, then we mention the IP address of or the address of the server instead of the local host. This JDBC is basically, I forgot to mention that this JDBC is the protocol that we mention in the URL, following which 3306 is the port number which helps us to uniquely identify the application, that is MySQL. Then following which the caps mobile is the database that we have created. Then anything after question mark is the string which actually helps us to know about the which gives us the access to establish the connection. So here in this case we are using the user is equals to root and password is also is equals to root. If you enter a wrong password, then you will come across an exception within the try block, and this exception, if you come across the print stack trace. So as mentioned that even though the driver will be loaded, but if you have a wrong password in this establishing the connection, this part of the code will not be executed. And as to verify, as we used to verify in driver loaded system, we used to verify by writing a system.println statement in the loading the driver step. In this, we will not be getting this as an output that the connection is not established. This is something which we will see in another part. Now, we will again pass in the connection. The connection, as mentioned, is a global variable. We declared here it to be null, but here now we assign it the value with the help of driver manager and get connection. Get connection is a method that we are using, which will have a return type of connection, and we are passing the URL in this get connection method. We can straight away write the URL, this entire part within this URL, but for our simplification, we have declared string URL differently, and we are passing it within the get connection method, and the return type will be connection as mentioned. So now we will print as a connection established, and so that to cross verify in the output that whether the connection has been established or not. And following which, if we have a try block, we will write the catch block with the a.print stack trace, so that if we come across any kind of exception, this will give the name, address and the message of the exception that we have come across. This video was all about the first two steps. We will see the remaining three steps in the next video. Thank you so much.